Sham, should I do business with my family members and friends? And this is what you're going to be covering in this video in 3, 2, 1. And here we go. Hello, everybody. My name is Sham, known in the community as a responsible restaurant owner. And for gosh, the last 10 years, I have been helping people open, run their restaurants out of the Silicon Valley, California. And about mid-2017, I started to share it with the world. So should you do business with family members and friends? Well, I've done both. I've done businesses, I did run businesses with family members, with friends, and with complete strangers. And this is a few pointers I would like to share with you. One, do not try and change your business partner. What you see is what you get. A lot of the times, people get involved in a business relationship or any kind of relationship for that matter, and they think that they can actually go ahead and change your business partner. Your business partner is not going to change. Two, no one is a psychopath. A lot of people do think that at one time or another, in moments of crisis, that the other member of the business equation is losing their mind. They are not. We are human beings, go through ups and downs, and what goes up must come down, and vice versa. Show vulnerability. You know, a lot of the time when people get into relationships, they always, business relationships or others as well, they always try to show their best face, that they're strong, that they know what they're doing, that they're solid, they're super confident, and that nothing is going to stop them and that they're always right. Please do be smart by show vulnerability. It is okay to say to your business partner, family, friends, or whatnot, to tell them, hey, I'm tired today, I don't feel on top of my game, you know, this project is getting on my nerves, whatever the situation may be, show vulnerability. And by doing that, by being the first one to do that, the other person is going to realize that, hey, you know what, I may have been pushing a little bit too hard on that person. Be emotional, but not too much. So here is the thing, lots of people sometimes in business relationship, they want to keep it all about business. This links a little bit to being a little bit vulnerable, in a sense that it's okay to show that you're emotional, that you're a human being, that you have flaws, that you're not perfect. Do not be scared of anger is number 4. Do not be scared of anger. Sometimes we do get angry, and if your partner or business partner gets angry, it's okay. As if they are sad, as if they're happy. We are living in a world nowadays where everybody is trying to have this amazing smile that shows that everything is going well all the time, and it is just not true. We have ups and downs, and your business partner needs to know that about you as you need to know that about themselves. Separate roles. You know, a lot of people come to me and tell me, oh, Sham, you know, the solution to that is that we just have separate roles. He does the front of the house, I'll do the back of the house. He will do the kitchen, I will do the office. But it is just not as simple as that. In order for a business to have harmony, one should be able to have access to any part of the other one's business without affecting the mood or the other one. Now, don't get me wrong. Whenever there is a business partnership, and most of the time, in my experience, I would recommend definitely have between 2 and 3 business partners. This is the challenge with being two in running an operation, is that all the time, one ends up being the alpha. What do I mean by that? One of them ends up being the stronger, more dominant, more aggressive one. And the second one normally is going to fold and be the more submissive, the more passive, the more think it's okay, like good cop, bad cop kind of thing. As soon as you start having like a third person in the equation, and that third person does not have to be an actual business partner. It's going to be just somebody that you trust, their feedback at their point of view. It's going to be a mentor. It's going to be a counselor. It's going to be a coach. It's going to be a family figure. Somebody that can come sometimes in between and create this kind of synergy and make sense. Because you know, when there is a tension in a business relationship, and you know what, when the business is doing good, everybody is happy. When the cashier is ringing, when people are coming, when everybody is getting paid, it's easy, we don't pay attention to anything. But when things are not going as planned, when pretty much you're not making the numbers you were planning to make, that's when some people fall into panic mode. And in this moment of panic mode, that lots of people try to point the finger. Stick to the system, do not get attached to the people, get attached to the system. Lots of restaurant owners out there go ahead and they make themselves necessary. Well, guess what? The cemetery is full of necessary people. I repeat, the cemetery is full of necessary people. So you need to be able to develop systems where anybody can come and do the system. I'm a big believer in checklists. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why do I have to rely on my memory while I have so many different things I need to memorize? Love your ego. You know, lots of people say, you know, when you have a restaurant business, you should let your ego go. Well, guess what? Ego is what gets you into the restaurant business on the first place. So cherish that, enjoy that. That's what keeps that fire going. That's what keeps you waking up in the morning. Protect your reputation. Help your partner protect theirs. Focus on the process once again, which means do not fall for just the technicalities. You know, he may have or she may have a different way of doing things. Focus on the process, focus on the results, focus on the systems. Have fun, definitely have fun. Lots of restaurant owners fall apart because that disappears. And for us, it's so easy to point the finger at the other business partner where we can focus on ourselves. Once again, I'm a big believer in destiny. So whatever is supposed to happen will happen. If we stick to the basics, you know, lots of people go into the restaurant business because they do not have a proper vision of what they want to make out of that restaurant. And I made that mistake. You know, the first restaurant I went in, I wanted to go into it in order to have fun. And I had lots of fun, but I was not a very good business person. And I was growing through this experience. So you need to have a very clear understanding with your potential business partner about the evolution and human psychology. Now, the thing is that when you do it with a family member or a friend, there is a level of trust. You know where they're coming from. And that to me is the most important factor when you establish a business relationship. Lots of people tell me, you know, I rather prefer to have somebody who is very knowledgeable. And knowledge is good. Nowadays, knowledge is available out there. But passion, somebody who gets your back, somebody who can tell you, hey man, you look tired today, why don't you go and take a couple of days of rest? Somebody who's really wants you to be happy, somebody who's not just trying to squeeze out of you every single inch of energy. And you're going to tell me, Sham, man, all my friends are lazy. Well, you know what? There is some of them that are going to hopefully improve. Maybe you should not do business with a friend of yours. But to me, the most important part, beyond whether it's a family member or friend, is the factor of trust. And to know that it's a business and to not get attached to what happens. You know, it's like in a relationship, lots of couples out there, one says, oh, I'm the good partner. No, I'm the good partner. Oh, I'm the good dad. Oh, I'm the good mom. It has nothing to do with that. The main important thing to focus on is the health of your child, aka the restaurant. Lots of people take it on ego trip. They do a couple of little things, but you know what? You are not perfect. Your business partner is not perfect. Nothing is perfect in this world, but your goal is to build something perfect. And that's why having a business partner that you trust that they're going to do their best. It doesn't mean that they're going to be the best ones in the world, but they're going to do their best. And guys, just for the perfectionist ones out there, there's lots of people that are like hardcore machines. I had some business partners. They were amazing. They were able to work 20 hours a day, every day for months, and they were doing fantastic. And I could not do that. I could not. I needed my 8-9 hours of sleep sometimes. And you know, and we had sometimes arguments about doing one's best. And just for the record, doing one's best does not mean that you're going to work yourself up to mental exhaustion. I repeat, doing your best does not mean that you have to work yourself up to mental exhaustion. Do you understand? I hope this was clear. Sorry for the thick accent. I don't think the accent is going to change anytime now. Once again, this was Sham, the responsible restaurant owner. Please comment. This page is for the community, so people may have the same questions. I did not cover everything. I probably did lots of mistakes, but hey, I'm out there trying to share my experiences. This is not something coming out of a book. This is literally something that I learned from my experience in the restaurant business and beyond. Once again, remember, the secret ingredient is love, and we will see you next time.